हेलो, माय वॉइस इज ऑडिबल? आर यू एबल टू हियर मी? कैन टाइप इन चैट और अनम्यूट योर सेल्फ एंड यू कैन स्पीक। So we are waiting for to join. Start within 2 minutes. So I am able to see only 5 students are there. Where are other students? So anyways, we are not wasting our time. I am going to share the presentation. And we will continue. Presentation is busy. All are able to see my presentation. You can reply. Yes or no? Hello. Yes, okay. So presentation is we are going to start. So our subject is a sticky way. And in last lecture, we have seen few concepts related to testing. So what is testing? Testing is the process of evaluating a system or its components with the intent to find whether that system satisfied the all requirement specified by the customer or not. Testing म्हणजे काय? आपण सॉफ्टवेअर टेस्ट करतो आणि त्यामध्ये कस्टमरने सांगितलेलं रिक्वायरमेंट आहे त्या फुलफिल झालेत का नाही त्या चेक करतो. येस. देन व्हॉट इज द स्टँडर्ड डेफिनेशन? द स्टँडर्ड डेफिनेशन इज अ प्रोसेस ऑफ अनालायझिंग अ सॉफ्टवेअर आयटम टू डिटेक्ट द डिफरन्सेस बिटवीन एक्झिस्टिंग अँड रिक्वायर्ड कंडिशन and to evaluate the feature of the software item. So this is the definition given by the ANSI, IEEE. So what is the meaning of this definition? So before this software there is existing system, but customer want to change that system, want some modification, and customer gives some requirement, I want system like this. And in testing we are comparing existing system with the required condition, and if we find some defects, errors, bugs in that, then we notify to the developer and we get that correct system what that customer require. Getting? Who does that testing? So in testing lot of peoples are involved, like in testing software testers are there, software developers are there, project managers are there, project lead is there, and last but not the least, end users means customer also test that system. So these peoples are involved in the testing. Are you getting this? Testing is not done by a single software tester. So everyone is doing testing of that system. So starting from the developer to the project manager, end users, all are doing testing with the software testers. Then what is actually software testing? In software testing, you just have to identify the bug or errors or defect in the software, and you don't have to correct it. Yes, you just have to notify the software developer, this is the problem in this code. Then software developer will correct that. So are you getting what is testing, who involved in testing, and how to do testing? You just have to identify the bugs, errors, and defects in the software, and no need to correct. That software developer, project manager, project lead will take care of that. Next, there are types of testings. So one testing, already I have given manual testing. Yes. So there are major two types: manual testing and automation testing. So what is the manual testing? So in the manual testing, software is tested manually. It does not, this in this type we don't use any automation tool or any script or any small program to run and test our application. So we have to, all we have to do manually. Getting all of you? What is manual testing? In this, we don't use any automation tool for testing our code. And what does in this testing? In this testing, testers takes over the role of end user and test the software. Yes, what tester does? Testers treat him or her like he is the end user, he is using the software, and they test the code and identify any problem, any bug, any runtime error, unexpected behavior of code. That tester will check, and this type of testing is called as manual testing. Are you getting what is manual testing? Then next, in manual testing, there are different stages like unit testing, integration testing, system testing, and user acceptance testing. These are the different stages in the manual testing. So when we see all the units in detail, you will learn all the testings. But still, I will give a brief overview. What is are the stages? Unit testing means what? In your software, there is a single module. So you are testing a single module. That is nothing but unit testing. Your software is a collection of different modules. So you are testing each modules, and that testing is called as unit testing. Then what is integration testing? You combine all the modules together and form a software, and you check that combined modules are giving proper functionality or not. That is nothing but integration testing. Are you getting? Software matlab fakt ek module check kela tar tala unit testing, ani sagle module combine karun te software check kela mhanje integration testing. Te ekmekat vyavasthit combine integrate zale ki nahi. Next, system testing, and last is user acceptance testing. So these are the different stages in the manual testing. Next, when you work as a tester, you have to use some documentary called as a test plan. You have to create test cases, you have to create a test scenario to test the software, so that you can check that software completely. As a tester, when you work as a tester, you have to create a test plan, how you are going to test this code. Then you have to give some test cases. Then some scenario in which condition you are executing that code. So this you have to first create, and then you can test your software. Then in manual testing, it includes the exploratory testing, in which you identify the errors in it. So you have to check all the code, and you have to identify where you are getting errors. Then manual testing, we have seen manual testing. Now we see automation testing. Yes, any doubt in manual testing? Again, see all the points, 5 points I have explained. What is manual testing, how to do that, which are the stages, and what you have to prepare, and last is the how to test. Then automation testing. So what is automation testing? So in automation testing, we use some tools, we write some script to test the software. It is called as automation testing. Automation testing is also known as test automation. So getting all of you? Automation testing, in which you use some script or softwares to test the software. So in automation testing, it is the process of automation of manual process. Ji apan agodar je manually code test karat hoto tes fakt ata automatically karayacha using some software or some scripts. So in automation testing, you can rerun the test scenario performed manually, quickly and repeatedly. So what was the drawback of manual system? You have to execute that code repeatedly, and you have to sit in front of computer for long duration. But in automation testing, you use software, you write some script, and you just run, and you can do your task. That tool will check your code. So this is the advantage of automation testing, that code will a test quickly and repeatedly you can do task, you will not get bored, because that testing will be done by the automation tool software. You just have to write a small script and you have to run, rerun and check all the test scenarios. It is passing the test or it is failing the test, like that. So in automation testing, there is another type of testing, that is a regression testing. You are testing that code repeatedly. That is nothing but a regression testing. So in automation testing also, you have to test the application from load, performance and stress point of view. So in automation testing, these are the processes that happen. First you have to load, then you have to check performance of that software, then you have to give stress to that system. So we can check what is the endpoint of that system, how many users that system can accommodate, and at what point breakdown of that software happens. Then in automation testing, it increases the test coverage. What are the advantages? It increases the test coverage. All the code is tested very well in automation. It improves the accuracy. Accuracy of automation testing is greater than the manual testing. Then it saves the time, because we are using software and scripts. Also, it saves the money, because if for manual testing, if that testing requires 5 testers, that automation testing can be done by the single or couple of testers. So these are the advantages of automation testing. So in industry, everywhere automation testing is happening. Then what to automate, which are the tasks we can automate? So for automation, there are some limitations. It is not possible to automate everything in the software. So which areas to be automate? So like that, if there are some transaction, then a login form or registration form, so that we can automate. Then a area in which large number of users are accessing some code simultaneously, that we should automate. Then all graphical user interface, connection with databases, some field validations, these tasks can be automated using tools. So getting all of you, what we can automate? We can automate all the graphical user interface, means that all the component in the graphical user interface are correctly loading or not. Second, connection with the databases. You are getting a connection with the database if multiple users are there, or at what point the database shows some error. Then field validations, if you are having some form, then it giving correct validations or not on all the browsers, so that we can automate. Then when to automate? So there is some scenario when we can automate, in which software we can automate. First is the large and the critical projects. If that project is very large and it is having some deadline, within few months we have to deliver that project, then we use automation testing for that. Next, in some projects, same areas to be tested frequently, then we can do automation testing for that. Then some requirements are not changing frequently in the software, then we can automate that testing. Then accessing the application for load and performance with many virtual users. If there are virtual users, then for manual testing it takes lot of time, but using automation testing within limited time also you can test that system. Then stable software with respect to manual testing, that you can automate, and availability of time. So in this scenario you can automate the testing. Then next, how to automate, how to apply this strategy. So in automation we use some computer languages like VB scripting or Java or Python to write the script for automation software application. There are a lot of tools are available which we can use to write automation script. Already I have told that you can write that automation script in Java language or Python or .NET, like that you are having plenty of options. So before mentioning the tools, first we have to identify the process that using that we can automate the testing. So how to do that? First step, identifying areas within the software for automation. So you can't test whole software using automation testing. So as already I have told that automation testing having some limitations. So first you have to identify which area to be tested using automation testing. That is the first step for automation. Second, selection of appropriate tool for test automation. You have to select appropriate tool according to the application and compatibility of that application. Next, you have to write the test scripts to run that code. So that is nothing but test scripts. That script we provide to the automation tool. Then you have to develop test suits. Next, when you write scripts, develop test tool, then next step is the execution of that script on automation tool. You have to execute that script. After execution we get the report. So you have to create a result reports. After that we can find what is the error, what is the potential bug, and what is the performance issue in this system. This is about the how we can automate the testing. So we can't automate whole software in automation testing. First we have to identify what to automate, which area to be automated, and give to the automation. Then select the tools, write test scripts, then develop test suits, execution of scripts, then create reports, and last identify the problems of that software. Then which are the tools, which are the automation testing tools we can use in automation testing? So first is the HP Quick Test Professional. This is the testing tool is there. Next, Selenium, most popular open source tool used in industry worldwide. Then tool by IBM Rational Functional Tester. Silk Test, this is another testing tool. Test Complete is another tool. Then Testing Anywhere, WinRunner, LoadRunner, Visual Studio Test Professional, So these are the few automation testing tools are there. In our syllabus, in Unit 4, we will see Selenium in detail and we will do testing using Selenium. Then there are some testing approaches. So first is the black box testing. So what you can tell about the black box? Have you learned already? You might have learned in software engineering. So can anyone tell what is black box? My voice is audible. So you can tell. Bharati, Priyanka. Unmute yourself and you can tell what is black box testing. Yes, I able to see all the students. Yes, Gandhi Rajasri, what is black box testing? Unmute yourself and you can speak. See, these are the all recorded videos. We will show to your parents if you are not participating. Gaikwad Mayuri. Burude Sneha. Kanchan Siddhanath, Pratiksha Kale, Priyanka Kolatkar, Pooja Shirke, Supriya, anyone can tell. So tell me, what is automation testing? Anyone, which are the tools are used for automation testing? Are you listening? Pratiksha Kale, which are the tools are used for automation testing? Priyanka Darekar. Which are the tools used for automation testing? Yogita.
Selenium.
Selenium, good. So Kanchan told Selenium is the automation testing tool. Priyanka. Pooja Shirke.
Visual Studio.
Visual Studio, good. Visual Studio is also automation testing tool. Gaikwad Mayuri.
Robotium.
Robotium. Where is the Robotium? So these are the automation testing tools. Major. So next, so be attentive in the lecture. Don't just log in and do your task. So these are the tools. After that, there are some approach for testing. First is the black box testing. So name suggests what is the approach. In this technique, we don't have knowledge of internals of that application. Still, we can test that application using black box approach. कळतंय तुम्हाला एखादं सॉफ्टवेअर दिलं आणि ते टेस्ट करायला सांगितलं तर त्याचं तुम्हाला त्यामध्ये काय यूज केलंय, कोणता कोड यूज केला आहे त्याचं नॉलेज नसेल तरी पण तुम्ही ते टेस्ट करताय, म्हणजे तुम्ही अप्रोच यूज करताय ब्लॅक बॉक्स टेस्टिंग. गेटिंग अ टेक्निक ऑफ टेस्टिंग without having any knowledge of internal working of that application is called black box testing. In black box testing, that testers don't have access to the source code. Yes, so you don't have to check what is the source code, what is the class is written, how object is created, which are the methods are written, which are the functions. So don't see the code. Then how that testing is happen? In black box testing, tester interact with the user interface and provide some input. So how you test? You execute that software, you get the graphical user interface. त्यामध्ये तुम्हाला काही इनपुट द्यायचं असेल, इनपुट दिल्यानंतर तुम्ही रन कराल ते किंवा सबमिट कराल आणि त्यानंतर तुम्हाला चेक करायचं आहे की तुम्हाला करेक्ट आउटपुट आलं की नाही ते. सो इन दिस वे यू आर टेस्टिंग द सॉफ्टवेअर युझिंग ब्लॅक बॉक्स अप्रोच. सो गेटिंग ऑल ऑफ यू, यू हॅव टू एक्झिक्यूट दॅट सॉफ्टवेअर, गिव पर्टिक्युलर इनपुट अँड यू हॅव टू चेक it is giving correct output or not. Either that software is passing the test or failing the test. That you have to check using black box testing strategy or approach. Then white box testing, so it is opposite of black box. So what is there in black box and what is in white box, we see. So in this testing, we are doing a detailed investigation of internal logic structure of the code. Black box मध्ये आपल्याला कोडचा access नव्हता, but in white box we are checking what is the code, what is the logic, we are investigating all the details, then what is the structure of that code. So this is opposite. White box testing is also called as glass box testing or open box testing. Yes, so there is another name for white box, glass testing or open box testing. So how to do this testing? In white box, the tester need to have knowledge of internal working of the code. So as in the white box, tester must have technical knowledge of how to write that code. Then the developer has already written the code, tester have to understand how that code is going to do functionality. Then in white box testing, tester have to look inside the source code, then find out which units, which modules, which chunks are functioning properly and which code, which units, which chunks are not functioning properly or giving inappropriate output. So for that, you have to test the units, modules, so you must have the knowledge of internal logic structures. So are you getting the difference between black box testing and white box testing? So both are opposite. In exam, question will be asked, differentiate between black box testing and white box testing. So few differences you can write. Then another difference in exam can be asked, what is difference between verification and validation? So there are 6 difference for 6 marks you have to write. So are you able to see my screen difference? So already I have written. So can anyone read? Kanchan, can you read first difference? What is the first difference? Can anyone read?
In verification, are you building it right? Or in validation, are you building the right things?
Good. So in verification, we are checking that we are building correct system or not. And in validation, after creating that particular software, we are checking that all the fields, text box is working fine or not, in that proper input is given by the users or not. That is validation. Then second difference, Pooja Shirke, can you read second difference? Pooja Shirke is there? Priyanka Darekar? Supriya Bagale?
In verification, ensure that the software system meets all the functionality, and in validation, ensure that functionalities meet the intended behavior.
Good. So in verification, we'll check that all the functionality that meets all the requirement of the customer, that is verification, all the functionality we have given in that software or not. And in validation, we have implemented all the functionality, but we are checking that that functionality is giving correct input, correct output or not for given input. That is, it is behaving correctly or not, or still there is an error. Then third, Priyanka Kolhatkar, can you read third difference? What is that?
In verification, take place first and include the checking for documentation, code, etc. In validation, validation occurs after verification and mainly involves the checking of the overall product.
Good. So what is in verification? We are checking all the documentation, code, that is written correctly or not. And in validation, that validation occurs after verification, and we are re-verifying that. That is, code is correct, documentation is correct for all the product. The next difference, verification is done by the developer and validation is done by the tester. Getting? The next difference, who will Borrowed Sneha. Borrowed Sneha is here in this lecture. Unmute yourself and read fifth difference, static activities and dynamic activities. Gandhi Rajasri. Bolo. Yogita.
In verification. In verification, as it includes the review via thread and inspection to verify the software is correct or invalidation have dynamic activities as it includes executing the software against the requirement.
Okay, so in verification we check the static activities in the testing, like a review of code, walkthrough, inspection of that code, and we verify that software is giving correct functionality or not. But in validation, we use some dynamic activity. Runtime, we are executing that code and we are checking that for given requirements are fulfilled by that software or not. Then we'll read last difference. Hina Alvi. Hina.
Sir, maja pude aahe na ti window purna black disti disanay tumche ppt chi slide.
Yes. In validation.
Window black disti sir, mala kai disanay.
Gaikwad Mayuri.
It is an objective process and no subjective decision should be needed to verify the software. In validation, it is subjective process and involves subjective decision on how well the software works.
Good. So in verification, the testing is the objective process, and in validation, it is a subjective process. You know that difference between objective and subjective. Yes, in objective you are having some options. In subjective you have to write the theory. Yes. So today we stop here. Write your names in chat for attendance. Or if you are having any doubt, then you can unmute yourself and you can tell any problem. So today we have seen what is testing, then major two types of testing, manual testing and automation testing. Then we have seen two strategies, black box testing, white box testing, and last point was difference between verification and validation.
Hello sir.
यस
सर माझा चॅटचाच ऑप्शन येत नाहीये.
चॅट ऑप्शन इज टेल युअर फ्रेंड टू राईट द नेम इन चॅट.
ओके सर. कांचन माझं नाव टाक गो.